Aniki, I can't fucking believe that you said this shit. I know this guy. He's in a Skype group that I participate in. I've spoken to this man. He's said nice things to me. He's complimented me. I can't believe that you said those things about fat chicks going to clubs. I'm a fat chick. If I want to go to a club, I'll go to a club and I'll shake my fat ass. And you, brother, if you don't like it, look the other way. Okay? I can't believe. I knew that you were a proponent of equal rights. I know that you say that you're a humanist, and I was all for supporting you in your beliefs and your ideas and your rights to having a different opinion on things other than, you know, the ones I have as a feminist. Cool. I want to get along with as many people as I can. I want to discuss things in a mature manner, and that's what we were doing. And then I hear you turn around and you make shit like that up? Come on, honey. You're better than that. As for pregnant women being out in public, it's not a sickness, it's not an illness. It should be something we celebrate and support because they're perpetuating the human race. So your mother did. Anyway, I probably won't be this mad later, so if you want to talk, we'll talk. But right now I'm going to vent. I wouldn't like seeing a pregnant woman in a club if there was smoking in that club. But the clubs here don't allow smoking, so if she wants to go dance, great! She's keeping in shape! Right on! Work out, honey! It's just... what's the problem? As long as she's not throwing back the Jack Daniels, which is her choice, not a bright one, but hers in the end. Who cares? People should be allowed to have fun no matter what shape, what color, what handy-able they are as a handicapped person. As much fun as they possibly can without hurting other people. And just because they look unpleasant to you doesn't mean they're hurting people. You can leave the bar. You can go to a different club. You can look the other way. You're a mature adult male, aren't you? You're better than this. As for where would women be without the birth control pill or your Congress in the United States allowing women to vote? Of course males invented and then wrote the pill because women were hardly, there were hardly any women at that time that were doctors because most of them weren't allowed to be doctors. In fact, women, it was illegal for women to practice being doctors in the early 20th century. Did you know that? There's a famous Canadian woman who was the first surgeon who later moved to the United States. I can only remember her first name and her nickname was Jenny Smiley. But her and her mother, who was just a physician, who was a physician as well, not a surgeon, practiced under threat of being imprisoned. So, it's of course a male invented the birth control pill. There were only probably 99% of the doctors at the time practicing were males! And Congress had to vote in something that a group of lobbyists, women, were pushing for many years and working very hard at because women were not allowed in Congress because if they were there, they would have voted for their right to vote. Come on, Aniki. I've spoken to you. You're brighter than this. Buddy, okay. I don't want to get mad. I hope that we can keep what I thought was a very good dialect open between the two of us, me as a feminist, you as a humanist, as you call yourself, but step back, honey. Take a look at yourself. Some of the shit that's falling out of your mouth, and you know, they did show me from your own videos, and I do know proportional response. If he says you were saying these things in the blog television, I tend to believe him. I'm not saying it's 100% true or it might be misconstrued, but he generally doesn't get it wrong. Next time you guys want to throw a blog like this, please invite me. Proportional response, you got my Skype. Cheers, everyone.